permineralization, not premineralization. YouTube, it's Cram. How do fossils form? They're not just bones that end up underground waiting to be dug out. Well, they kind of are. The word fossil itself comes from the classical Latin word fossilis, which means obtained by digging. But as we know, some fossils can be obtained without digging. There are four types of fossils: mold, cast, traced, and true form fossils. Mold fossils are impressions without the bones themselves. Cast fossils are basically mold fossils but are filled in, typically with minerals. Trace fossils are traces of the existence of the creature, such as nests, burrows, or tracks. True form fossils actually have parts of the animal, typically bones. There are many types of true form fossilization, but two main kinds are unaltered preservation and premineralization, which is what we'll be focusing on today. Unaltered preservation is most common in insects and other small creatures. It is when they are trapped in a thick substance which hardens, preserving all parts of their body. This substance is typically amber, which is hardened tree sap. Premineralization is when rock-like minerals seep into the animal and replace its organic tissue and bone. This is why fossilized animals seem to have denser bones. It is because of the minerals that seeped in. One way this can happen is in a body of water. The animal will settle at the bottom and the decomposition process will be greatly slowed by the surrounding water. Eventually, sediment will cover the body and more layers of rock will cover it up. This pressure will cause premineralization. Eventually, due to geological forces, the fossils may be closer to the surface or even above ground where we can discover them. Though now with technology and our knowledge of migration patterns and habitats, we can accurately predict and find fossils underground. In the past, we had to rely on chance to stumble upon a great fossil. I hope you enjoyed this video as much as I appreciated you watching. Subscribe to stay up to date on all my latest science videos. And until next time, Cram out!